Hi my dear friends, good morning. Today topic is TDS end user process or withholding tax end user process. This is very important for all end users. Even this is very important for consultant also. Okay, sometimes interviewer will ask the question how the accounting entries will be generated. So in this video, what scenarios we will cover? Let's see, this is the four scenarios we will discuss in this video. Example, TDS on invoice posting, TDS on payment posting, TDS plus GST posting, and TDS on advance payment. So this is the four scenarios I can cover in this video. It's a very important. Let's go and watch. Everyone, the first one, TDS on invoice posting. If you post vendor invoice, the T code is called FB60. If you post vendor invoice, T code FB60, how the accounting entry will generated? How the accounting entry will generated? Better note it down one accounting entry. TDS is, note it down one account, I mean, note it down one note. Note it down one note. TDS is applicable for all services. All services. Okay. For example, rent is one of the services. Okay. Like, you know, like if you post vendor invoice, how the accounting entry will generated? Example, rent account data and to vendor Maurya Private Limited to TDS on rent. Example, rent is 20,000 rupees, vendor Maurya Private Limited is 18,000 rupees and TDS on rent 2,000 rupees. And against of this invoice, if you post vendor payment, like Maurya Private Limited account data to cash, 18,000 and 18,000. Let's see how you can post accounting entry in SAP. Everyone, better note it down this accounting entries and same accounting entries, same scenario, how to post in SAP. Let's go to SAP and go to FB60. Press enter button in the keyboard. It's going on browse. Wait for some time. Yeah. First check the company code. Is this your company code or not? Then let's take the vendor. Let's take the vendor. Example, Maurya Private Limited. This is the one. And as usual, document date, posting date, whatever date you know, and reference invoice posting, then text being vendor invoice posting, here GL, here you want to take the rent, here you want to take rent, example, and 440031 rent. The amount is called 20,000 rupees and use tap and business area and profit center. Press enter button in the keyboard. Enter again and copy this amount, paste it here, press enter again. When it is green, then only you can click on withholding tax tab here. When it is not green, don't go to withholding tax tab. Okay, when it is green, then click on your withholding tax tab. And see here, everyone, there is an two objectives here, TDS on invoice and TDS for payment. TDS for invoice posting and TDS for payment posting. Now my scenario is, I want to post the TDS at the time of invoice posting. Then you can remove tax code for payment. You can remove this tax code. Then press enter button in the keyboard and click on your simulate and enter. Simulate and enter. And enter again, once again. This is just for the information pop-up. See this one, everyone. This is the simulation accounting entry. Like rent account data, 40 means rent account data, 31 means credit to vendor, and 50 means credit to TDS on rent. So this accounting entry is good. Then click on your post. It's going on browse. Wait for some time. Means it is picking all the configuration. If your configuration is good, then accounting entry can post. If configuration is not good, accounting entry throw out the error message. In case if you want TDS configuration, let's see my previous videos. Okay, I did very good configuration on TDS. It's going on browse. Wait for some time. See this one, document has been posted. Let's go to document and click on your display. See this one, 40 means debit, rent account data, 31 means credit to Maurya Private Limited to 194i TDS on rent. This is the invoice posting accounting entry. So what is the vendor value? Vendor value is 18,000. Total expenses is 20,000. Less TDS. Now, everyone. Now, I want to post like a payment posting. Vendor payment posting. Let's see how the accounting entry will generate it. Vendor account data means Maurya Private Limited account data. To cash and bank, whatever. 18,000. Why I am taking 18,000? Let's see here. Vendor value is 18,000 only. Why? Because total expenses is 20,000, but less TDS. Then I want to pay 18,000. If you pay 18,000, but 20,000 is going to clear. Let's post vendor payment. What is the T code? T code is called F-53. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then as usual, document date, posting date, you know very well. Document date, posting date, reference, vendor payment. And here you can take cash or bank GL. I'm taking cash GL 220000. Amount is 18,000. Then here you can take the vendor. Open item means here you want to take the vendor, and vendor is Maurya Private Limited, and click on your process open item. Click on your process open item, then go to document and simulate and post. And go to document and display. Do one thing, guy. Let's check the vendor report. What is the vendor line item report T code? FBL1N. FBL1N is vendor line item report. Vendor line item report. Go to FBL1N. Press enter button in the keyboard. then go to vendor number. Who is that vendor? Like Mauryan Private Limited. Maurya Private Limited. Then click on your all items. Then click on your execute. So this one. This is the one. Note it on one note. Better note it on one note. In the FBL 1N, tax value cannot appear here. Tax value cannot appear. Not only TDS, even GST value also cannot appear here. In FBL 1N. Yeah. Now, let's see another scenario. Everyone, let's see another scenario. This is one more scenario. TDS on payment posting. At the time of post vendor invoice, FB60, rent account data to Maurya Private Limited, 20,000. Now, I cannot calculate TDS on invoice. In this scenario, I want to calculate TDS on at the time of payment. This is different scenario, guys. That is different scenario, and this is different scenario. In this scenario, I want to calculate TDS on payment. Better note it down the accounting entries. How the accounting entries will going to generate. Okay, and let's go to FB60. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then as usual, vendor number, Maurya Private Limited. Then as usual, document date, posting date, reference, whatever you want. Then being vendor invoice posting, then rent amount is example 20,000. Then use tab, business area, and use tab, profit center. Press enter button in the keyboard, enter again. Then copy this amount, control C, and paste it here. Press enter again. Now it is in a green, and now you want to click on your withholding tax. Enter again. Now I want to calculate TDS on at the time of payment posting. Then you can remove the tax code on invoice. You can keep the tax code on payment. TDS for payment of rent HP. Yeah. This is the tax code, guys. Now press enter button in the keyboard. Enter again. Then click on your post, whatever. And go to document and click on your display. See this one. Why now it can't be calculated TDS? Why? Because I gave direction. I don't want to calculate TDS on at the time of invoice posting. I want to calculate the TDS on payment posting. Okay, let's go back. Now guys, let's see here how you can post. How you can post payment at the time of TDS payment posting. This is the accounting entry. How the accounting entry will generate it? Maurya Private Limited account data to cash to TDS. To cash and to TDS. TDS nothing but withholding tax. Let's go to F-53. Press enter button in the keyboard. then as usual document date, posting date, whatever date you want. And here you can take cash and bank GL. I'm taking cash GL. Now amount. So how much amount I'm paying, guys? How much amount I'm paying? I am paying only 18,000. If you pay 18,000, but 20,000 invoice will going to clear. Let's see here. I'm paying only 18,000. So here you can take 18,000. 18,000. Then use tap. Then take the vendor, Maurya Private Limited. Then click on your process open item. Let's try to analyze here, everyone. This is my invoice value, 20,000. And I'm paying 18,000 only. But why it is showing zero? Why? Because it is calculated TDS automatically. Let's see. Click on your withholding tax tab here. Withholding tax tab. Now you can understand here. Now you can understand. This is my invoice value, 20,000. This is my TDS value. TDS nothing but withholding tax. And this is my payment value, 18,000. The finally, it's going to nullified zero. It's going to nullified zero. Then click on here, go to document and simulate. Go to document and simulate. Let's see here how the accounting entry will generate it. Then post. Go to document and display. Let's see here, everyone. What happened? Like vendor account data, Maurya Private Limited account data, two cash, two TDS. So same accounting entry, guys. Same accounting entry, this one. Vendor Maurya Private Limited account data, two cash, two TDS. So this is the process. This is the process of TDS calculate on payment. Now, one more scenario. Guys, try to understand one more scenario. One more scenario. This is the scenario. TDS plus GST posting. Dual tax. Dual tax. Now, try to understand here. Example, my total rent value. Total rent value is 1 lakh rupees. Total rent value is 1 lakh rupees. Plus input CGST 6000 rupees. Plus input SGST 6000 rupees. Means like 6% and 6%. And the total amount is 1,12,000. Then less TDS 10,000 rupees. Everyone, please note it down. Note. TDS will calculate on base amount. TDS will calculate on base amount. Okay. So TDS never calculate on this 1,12,000. TDS will calculate on 1 lakh only, means base amount. So less TDS and 10,000 rupees, total invoice value or vendor value 1,02,000. So my request is, please put on hold in this video. Note it down, accounting entry. Note it down your own. How the accounting entry will generate it. Try your way. What is the accounting entry for this? For this scenario, what is the accounting entry? Put on hold this video. Take pen and paper. Note it down. Just imagine or just noted how the accounting entry will going to generate it. Okay. Now, post vendor invoice, like example, vendor invoice is called FB60. In this FB60, this is the scenario I want to post. Very, very important, guys. Dual tax. Okay. Let's go to, everyone, concentrate here. Let's go to FB60. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then as usual, Maurya Private Limited. Maurya Private Limited, then document date, posting date, whatever date you want. Then being vendor invoice posting, then rent, amount is 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh rupees. You tap business area and profit center. And profit center, everyone try to understand here. Press enter button in the keyboard, enter again, then click on your calculate tax. Click on your calculate tax, press enter again. Here, take the tax code. Example, I want input CGST and input SGST, both I want. Select here, and in line item also, you can take the tax code here. In line item also, you can take the tax code H2. Then press enter again and copy this amount. So here tax did not add on. If tax, input tax did not add, then go to editing options. Go to editing option, click on here, calculate the tax on net amount. If indirect tax cannot add on your base amount, then click on your editing option, click on calculate tax on net amount, then go back. See this one, immediately it's going to add indirect tax, add on base amount. TDS is less on base amount. Okay, so click on here, copy this amount, Control C and paste it here. Press enter button in the keyboard. See now it's on a green. Then click on your tax, withholding tax. And now I want to calculate the TDS at the time of invoice posting. Then remove the payment. Now press enter again and go to document and simulate. Go to document and simulate. See this one, how the accounting entry going to generate. Let's check your accounting entry. You are noted, right? Then click on your post. Go to document and display. Now let's see the accounting entry. Everyone, rent account data 40 means debit. Rent account data, input CGST account data, input SGST account data to Maurya Private Limited to TDS on rent. So this vendor and TDS going to credit, and this expenses and GST will going to debit. I'm repeating once again, this expenses for 40 means debit. Expenses plus GST is on a debit. Vendor and TDS is credit. Let's see here. Let's see the vendor value is on a minus credit value. TDS value is also minus credit value. These three values is a plus value, means debit value. Okay, let's note it down, accounting entry. Sometimes interviewer will ask this accounting entry, guys. Now the last scenario, everyone. Last scenario, TDS on advance payment for special GL transaction. If you want special GL configuration, let's see my previous videos. Okay, and how to post advance payment, F-48. Go to F-48, see this one, Maurya Private Limited account data, 2 cash and 2 TDS on rent. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then as usual, document date, posting date, you know very well, right? Document date, posting date, and vendor payment, whatever. Here, let's take the vendor. Maurya Private Limited, and A for special GL transaction, the account cash or bank GL, cash 220000. What is the year you want to take? Total value, guys, total value. Okay, total vendor value. Example 1 lakh rupees, then click on here, press enter or new item. And example 1 lakh rupees, 1 lakh rupees, then due on, example today date. Due on means, example, let's take today date. And business area and profit center, and here you want to write the narration being whatever vendor advance payment, whatever you want. Then if you want to check TDS details, you can click on this one. Better click on this if you want to check. Let's see here, this is the one, HP is updated for the payment, only HP. Okay, then go to document and click on your simulate and press enter, guys, press enter. This one TDS will updated automatically. Then post, go to document and display. So this is the one. So vendor account data, Maurya Private Limited account data, 2 cash, 2 TDS. Okay. So thanks everyone. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.